A vagabond man breaks into a wedding, takes the microphone out of the singer's mouth and becomes famous throughout the world. Vladimir walked along the central street in the evening. He didn't even walk. He was looking for something. He's been constantly looking for money. You're working for money. They especially agreed to take it, mainly because of public convictions by analysis. What does it mean to blame? Vodka, drugs, or a prison? And also these frequent mentions that the homeless like this way of life, and their personal choice, and if they get a job, then certainly in order for something, then steal and run away. Passing by the restaurant where the wedding was going on, Vladimir stopped, looking into the windows, was about to leave and began to walk on, and just at that time a drunk guy came out of the cafe. They collided. "Hey," the guy shouted at Vladimir. More accurately, the man apologized and went around that went further, but the young man called out to him, "There is a smoke." "I don't smoke," the guy snorted, glancing at the man. "It's expensive nowadays to choose between vodka and a cigarette, and I do not choose, I ignore," Vladimir calmly said. "It is harmful to health." "Yes, health will come in handy on the street." Then he took a lighter out of his pocket and lit a cigarette. Show that he just hooked a homeless person to make fun of him. "I do not complain on the street. You don't need to pay for your charms. For example, you don't need to pay a communal apartment." Vladimir was found. "Yes, a communal apartment is a ripoff again. The government raises this topic." The guy blew smoke from his mouth and shivered. It was still chilly outside, and he was in suit trousers and a light shirt. "And you generally have news how you look. You collect rumors. Sometimes there is more truth than from TV," Vladimir noted. "You walk around the city, you learn all the news from conversations with expert assessments of ordinary people, and that was the time to lose nerves." He knew that there was a family, but they remembered almost nothing. No names or addresses, no phone numbers, only some phrases, warm memories of his beloved woman, and a smile, his face, and everything else as if in a haze. The sonorous laughter of children is not sure, that's all or not, but a blonde boy of 8 years old, an older boy with a girl of 12 years old, everything is cut off. Vladimir was sure of one thing: if he meets them, he will remember everything for sure, and the family lives in the basement again. His boyfriend touched a sore subject. This drunken young man, most of all Vladimir wanted to return to his family, but he only remembered that he had gone to work as a watch as a result of money he was not paid as promised. They demanded to continue work, then they will give everything to the campaign at once, but Vladimir already realized that it was a deception. He wanted to look for something else to help his family, but his documents were taken away and generally kicked out of the construction car into the street. The man found himself without a livelihood on the street, spent the night at the entrance. There he met local homeless people who beat him for entering their territory, took everything that he had of value, including his phone. As a result of that fight, he was taken to the hospital, but he has no documents with him, no money, and homeless people do not keep them in the hospital for a long time. They put them on their feet and thanks for that, but only with the memory. There was a trouble. The blackouts were as if some pieces of the puzzle were lost. Who is he? He isn't from where. He did not remember. He tried to return to the watch to pick up the documents, but there were no longer these scammers. Since then he walked the streets, made friends with other homeless people. They shared information where you can spend the night and get free food. Gradually began to remember the past. But no matter how tried, this moment about his home, clothes and familiar people as if cut out of his head. Vladimir scowled at the tipsy guy who was having fun teasing the bum. A couple more guests came out to breathe fresh cigarette air. "Prove that you are worth something," the guy suggested, and pulled out a purse from the back pocket of his trousers. "Go to the restaurant now, take a microphone and sing something." The guy pulled out a bill at random. It turned out to be a 5,000 banknote. "If you do, and if you are building," the guy thought, and then added, "it doesn't matter, you still have nothing. I don't want to dirty your hands." Vladimir looked at 5,000. With this money he can ask the conductor, or buy a ticket without documents. Does not matter how to come up with something. The man really needed money, and the guy, although drunk, must keep his words, and Vladimir agreed. Other guests witnessed the couple and prepared their phones to laugh at the dirty homeless. The instigator was in a good mood in anticipation of fun. He did not even go far into the restaurant hall, prepared to shoot closer to the exit when he will be turned off. Go out of the restaurant, and Vladimir knew two things. The first, he really needs money. The second, the key to success is confidence. With an imperturbable face, he walked as a DJ whispered something in his ear, then went to the Toastmaster, winked at him and took the microphone from him. While the Toastmaster looked distractedly around, the music began to play. One of the guests was already running to the stage to send the uninvited, untidy guest away. Others watched in confusion what would happen next, but Vladimir began to sing. "You know how you want to live, to enjoy the crimson sunrise, to live to just love everyone who lives next to you." With every word of the song, people running towards him slowed down, and when they approached the stage they just froze. There was silence in the restaurant when the melody was just playing in a heartfelt voice that grabs the soul sounds. No one moved, everyone froze. No one heard such a wonderful living voice for a long time. When Vladimir finished, he looked around embarrassed and hurried to leave the stage, until people had time to come to their senses, passing by the organizer to the couple who stood with the phone and did not turn on the lousy. Vladimir stretched out his hand to him. The young man woke up from his stupor and gave the homeless 5,000, an excellent gift for the young. Bewildered, he smiled after the fleeing man. A few moments of silence and then people applauded. Some women could not hold back their tears, but the performer of the song was gone. Vladimir almost ran away from the restaurant. He did not know how people would react to his trick. He took the silence in the hall for a shock state as a reaction to an intruder. Everything inside him was boiling. In this song he put all his feelings and experiences he thought about to his wife and children. It seemed to him that their faces were acquiring clear outlines and he was about to see them. And now he was even more sure that soon all his troubles would end. He would come home and, certainly arriving in his hometown, he would remember everything, find his house. First of all, Vladimir ran to the station. He had more money than he needed for a ticket. He had already looked for a second hand where he could buy something clean for a long time. Tomorrow he is going home. Meanwhile, at the wedding, they discussed a mysterious performer. Impressionable, the bride wanted to thank him by all means for such a wonderful gift, although the guy who lost to the homeless couple claimed that the singer received a good fee. The girl insisted on finding this person. It was built that no one knows his name. Listen, and I recorded a video. One of the men who witnessed the dispute between a homeless man and a drunk guy showed his phone. Let's start, maybe someone will recognize him. So the video with this song spread across all social networks. She became very quickly viral. People, having learned that they were looking for a mysterious performer who made the wedding unforgettable, shared the video on YouTube, TikTok, on Instagram and wherever they could. Meanwhile, Vladimir smoothed his sweater bought yesterday in a secondhand shop, looked around for the last time in the mirror in the toilet of the carriage, and excitedly walked to the door. There were a few minutes left to his station. He wanted to get off first. He didn't sit forever. The crossings were busy, the conductors were purring, they're ready to jump out to the wedding right on the go. If you're late, I'm late to live late, Vladimir said excitedly. Be careful when jumping off the train, otherwise we'll have time. The conductor shook her head displeased, but Vladimir did not pay attention to her mood. He felt that now his life would change. But apart from joy and excitement, there was a lot of what if his wife and children would not accept him back. Maybe they think they left them when the train arrived. Vladimir's legs were shaking with excitement. I looked around at Station Square, a familiar place, but immediately the smile disappeared from his face, where he did not remember where to go further. You can take a picture with you. A couple of teenagers distracted him from his thoughts. Vladimir was puzzled, but the young people had already settled in next to him and the man smiled in bewilderment at the camera. The teenagers thanked him and left whispering. Vladimir thought that the youth just decided so to have some fun, but after a while they again paid attention to him. Oh, it's you, a respectable woman jumped up to him. You can take a photo for memory here, as if something was wrong. The man thought it didn't seem like a woman was having fun, or maybe some actress plays so skillfully. Someone decided to play a trick on him, some kind of hidden camera. As you go, a woman chirped enthusiastically. I am delighted that you studied somewhere where you sing. It is so wonderful that you are from our city. I came with pleasure and listened to you. The woman kept chatting and I could not get to Vladimir what she was talking about. Oh, I'm late, what a pity. The woman caught herself. Tell me where you can listen to. I don't know, actually. Singing, this is not my job. Vladimir was confused. What a pity, you absolutely need to sing. The woman took a selfie with him. You look so good in the frame, maybe we will exchange phones. I have no jealous wife, hurried to get rid of the stranger Vladimir. Later he sat on a bench and came to his senses, decided that the woman just wanted to get to know him. He sat and did not know what to do, looked in front of him and thought where to go now, closed his eyes and strained his brain trying to remember something. Again, before he had an image of his wife, and a smile and a vague silhouette. He sat like that for a while. Then he opened his eyes. Gradually the image began to take on some distinct outlines, low, slightly plump, long blonde hair gathered in a tail in the back, large eyes that cover half the bangs and the wind blows unruly hair. She wipes it out of her eyes with a perplexed smile. Marina, Vladimir said. He remembered everything, his wife and children who are already more than sometimes he thought. Maxim finishes the 8th grade, Alena is the last, is going to study journalism, and Vlad is studying for a programmer in college. Marina was now standing in front of him. That's why her image became so clear. Vladimir did not believe his eyes. He cried and rushed to her. His wife, like many other people, saw a viral video in which she recognized her husband. They discussed the mysterious artist on social networks and Marina joined this discussion. Now people were looking for Vladimir together. Those two teenagers who were the first to recognize the man at the station launched a photo under a general search hashtag. Marina, who was tracking the news, quickly saw the photo and rushed to the station. The woman was not angry with her husband. She did not think that he left her. She was worried and was waiting for him. Already at home, she told Vladimir that he had became famous throughout the country, and the man was ashamed that he had become famous in such an unpleasant form. The daughter of the novice blogger promised to fix it. Since then, Vladimir's family no longer needed money. Now the man had to go on a watch. He and his wife kept their blog and was invited to the event as a singer. Recovering from all the troubles and getting back on their feet again, Vladimir began to help people who find themselves in a difficult life situation. He also tried to convey to others that not all homeless people are bad. Not everyone makes a choice in favor of the street. Perhaps they got into such a situation because of deception like him, and then before turning to them attention and lending a helping hand, the more chances to change their life. Thank you all for your attention.